Yakov 22, thank you so much for the super chat effort. Yakov having some issues contributing there. I don't know what the answer is there, Yakov, but we appreciate the try there. You can contribute to the channel as well by using Amazon, using the link that we provide in the description section. You got Tony Gerdeman on the line from Buckeye Scoop, Kevin Noon, Buckeye Grove, Steve Hellwagon, of course, senior Big Ten writer at 247 Sports Bucknuts. Tony, you had brought to the table before we started to record the black stripes have been lifted from a few players. You'll do a better job of explaining more accurately exactly what that is as those particular players have proven themselves as Buckeyes.
Yeah, anytime all new Buckeyes have a black strip of tape put on their helmet, and they have to prove themselves in practice and workouts and things like that. And once they have done that, then a player, you know, after a good practice or what have you, will can get his black stripe removed, and then he becomes an official member of the team. And so that has happened three times this spring. The first one was redshirt freshman Jacoby Cowan, a defensive lineman, who was hurt all last year and so never really had an opportunity to practice and get that black stripe removed. This past week, it was Marvin Harrison Jr., the freshman wide receiver, was the first one, followed by Jack Sawyer, defensive end. I don't think either are gigantic surprises. Jack Sawyer was probably the betting favorite to be the first member of the 2021 class to have it removed. And I say he was the second just because that's the order they were announced in following practice, because that's when it happens. It's after practice. So it's not like, well, first Marvin and then Jack Sawyer. It's just, well, one has to go first. And so, and then Marvin Harrison Jr., the son of an NFL Hall of Fame wide receiver, you would expect. He's really impressed some people. He's a big kid, 6'4", probably, you know, 210, something like that. He looks legitimately like an ex receiver right now. And so those two guys, by the merits of their practice halfway through spring, which is, it's not completely unheard of, but it's really hard for true freshmen to get their black stripes removed in the spring. So don't lose sight of that fact either.
Yeah, we certainly.
Go ahead, Jeff.
I was just going to say we're not that far removed from the first time a true freshman, an incoming freshman, an early enrollee lost his black stripe during spring practice. Generally, it wasn't until fall practice, and then they would kind of trickle out at the beginning, and then, you know, they would happen a little bit of a quicker order. But I'll remind everybody on the black stripe program that Urban Meyer started, they're not benchmarks there. That, you know, you don't have to go out there and lift a certain amount of weight and make a certain amount of plays or whatever. It's very much a motivational tool or whatever. A lot of people get worried why player XYZ still has his black stripe on or whatnot. Coaches know what they're doing there. It's a motivational tool in a lot of ways. Some guys need the reward of losing that black stripe once they've earned it. You know, it's not just we're going to take it off just because we think you need a cookie or something. But, you know, some guys perform better in that instance, and some guys perform better being pissed off that they still have it and seeing their three sweet mates over there at the Towers all without their black stripe, and they still have it, and they, you know, and it pushes them to drive harder and do more. So again, there's not a chart. You know, Ryan Day isn't walking around with an index card checking little boxes off for each of these guys to decide when it's time to take their stripe off.
Yeah, just a tremendous tribute to those guys, how hard they've worked since they've been at Ohio State. That's got to get the endorsement of, you know, the senior leadership council. You know, Mick Marotti, the head coach, the coordinator, the position coach, his big brother. Everybody's got to kind of be on the same path with that. And, you know, I think it's a good roadmap to tell you who some of these guys are who are going to get to play. I think it was good. Jacoby Cowan, I think, got his off, and he's a holdover from last year as a freshman and didn't get to play. I think he may or may not have been banged up last year as well, but a good sign for him that maybe he's healthy and can help him as well on the defensive line. So, you know, you look at it, a lot of positive things coming up when you see that those young guys are kind of passing that initiation test and becoming full-fledged Ohio State football, sacred brotherhood team members.
sometimes my brain makes an odd connection. So when Tony was explaining that even though they both were being stripped of the black stripe, that obviously there's an order to the announcement, you know, much like Hall of Fames, like I've heard this trivia question a number of times. Who's the first inductee to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame? And I believe it's Chuck Berry, because he's alphabetically in front of Elvis Presley, Johnny Cash, Jerry Lee Lewis. But there were like seven of them inducted. So just technically it's Chuck Berry, but there were like seven of them included. So, all right. Good stuff from all of these gentlemen. Of course, as usual, for a 100th time, we docked Kevin for about 10 shows. But again, Tony Gerdeman, Buckeye Scoop, Kevin Noon from Buckeye Grove, and Steve Hellwagon from 247 Sports on Bucknuts. And you got to check out the work with these guys that they do all the time. And I want to give proper time to your other online appearances. So, Tony, we'll start with you, and everybody lock in on these.
Yeah, you can check out my podcast, the Buckeye Weekly Podcast, usually every Tuesday and Thursday. Me and Tom Moore talking all things Ohio State, and you can find me at BuckeyeScoop.com any other time.
Yeah, you can catch me on the BIA podcast, Buckeye Grove Instant Access. I wish I could give you a schedule, but haven't been real reliable on that as of late. We'll get better. Going to be hitting the road here next week doing some recruiting coverage out of state, so check out all of that over at BuckeyeGrove.com.
Yep, I'm just at Bucknuts.com. I do participate in our Bucknuts Morning 5 every now and then. Something that we post every morning, usually around 8:30 to 9:30, a quick 5 or 10 minute podcast of what's happening in the day's events. Usually Dave Biddle or Dan Rubin are on it, and I'm on there sometimes. But yeah, that's all we got going on. And obviously spring football, we're kind of moving into the home stretch now with the game on April the 17th. And looking forward to wrapping up the spring with everything else that's going on. And I'll also be doing a little bit of recruiting coverage over the weekend, maybe some basketball, maybe some football. So no shortage of things happening at Ohio State.
Lewis reminds everyone in the live chat, please share the links to the videos out there on social media. We got a number of questions coming in that were topics that had been covered. So again, if you jumped in 10 or 15, 20 minutes late, most likely we covered your topic. So wait for the video to post in about 5 to 10 minutes and check it out from the start. Guys, it's always appreciated. Hope everyone out there appreciates what these three bring to the table each and every week. For 100 shows in the books, Ohio State Buckeyes Live. Thanks, guys.
Take care.